best game face playoff?
Alonzo Mourning?
No, this guy next to us. Like, show him your game face.
Alonzo had a good game face, too.
Stop it. You look at this guy's game. Look at this guy's game face. Show him.
Let me see your game face.
You know what, Kenny? I lost it. I can't do it.
Let me see your game face. That is frightening.
Oh, wait.
That's not a game foot. That's not a game look. That's your game book look. I can't do it anymore.
Here's a guy with no game face, Kevin Harlan.
Until morning.
From Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, 2K Sports proudly brings you the Thunder at the Peak at the Chesapeake Energy Arena. So for the Thunder, their last game, a loss to Golden State in Oakland.
And no matter how well you defend, when you shoot that poorly, it's going to be a very difficult challenge for you to get a win.
Yeah, there was sort of a snowball effect in that game too, guys. I mean, what started as a cold night for a few guys turned into a cold night for just about everybody.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. On the floor for Boston. Thomas is the point with Bradley to his side. Jared Sellinger is out there with Amir Johnson. And it's Crowder at the three, and he gets it to go.
You know, it's hard not to think of great shooting when you think of Kevin Durant. What he's really worked on over the past few years, though, is his playmaking. He's averaging 4 to 5 assists a game these days. Impressive.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal. And then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And Greg, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
That indicates the importance of great on-the-ball defense, as was displayed right there.
And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook. Durant's got his second bucket of the night. Getting back to Durant's playmaking, it's something we've seen Jordan do, it's something we've seen Kobe, you know, master. It helps those guys win championships.
Yeah, scoring yourself is great, but when you're trying to win rings, you have to trust and believe in others. And at this point in Kevin's career, he's all about that ring.
And so it's Boston with it, following the score by Oklahoma City. And Thomas, here we go. Pulls up on the elbow. The shot is off. And Oklahoma City will go with it to handle the Celtics.
A huge margin of victory for them when these two teams squared off last. And they got scoring from up and down their lineup.
Yeah, the reserves, the guys coming off the bench, Greg, made their presence felt. And, of course, with their big lead, they were able to give the bench a lot of run.
Already seizing control of this game.
Total control, Greg, and as well as they're playing at both ends, I look for this lead to get even larger.
Now here's Crowder. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Atlanta. And there's the call on Durant. That is his first foul of the game. And Oklahoma City going with a whole new group out there. First quarter of basketball, just over 2.5 minutes play. We know Oklahoma City has the stars, the big names, the offensive flair. But, you know, Greg, this team, and you appreciate this, is a very tough defensive group.
Yeah, I think they've matured in that area. In the past, that wasn't always true. But last year, the Thunder really hung their hat on their defense. Top 10 in opponents' field goal percentage.
And the shot's good from Crowder. Game for the Celtics, it was a loss to the Atlanta Hawks.
And I really felt in watching that game that they needed to abandon the three-point shot. It wasn't there, the percentage was horrific, but yet they continued to try and knock them down.
And I really think that's what did them in. I mean, sometimes it's just not there for you on the perimeter, and you can't try to shoot yourself out of a bad shooting night from outside.
Mitch McGarry's checked in for Oklahoma City. Morrow comes in for Payne. So Boston going with almost an entire new group. Olynyk is checked in for Sullinger. Jurepko comes in for Amir Johnson. Evan Turner, he's checked in for Jay Crowder. And Smart subbed in for Bradley. And now, the first timeout called here for Boston.
Yeah, just frustrated by their lack of production offensively, and I can't blame them. I mean, they're getting the looks, but the shots just aren't falling.
Yeah, and the slump that they're having shooting the ball can take its toll on you if you're not mentally strong. So I like this timeout here to try to get those guys reset and refocused.
Checked in for Oklahoma City. And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. On the wing, Turner. Good, and the assist goes to Thomas. Turner's got it back down to a single-digit deficit for the Celtics. For Oklahoma City, they've gone 7-8 from the field to start the game. Very hot shooting.
And Isaiah Thomas traded last season from Phoenix over to Boston. Seemed to be a matter of fit and not production as to why they moved him.
And pushing it up here, here is Oklahoma City and Waiters with the stuff.
It's taken them no time to build this lead up. Great first quarter offensively.
But no time to relax here. They've got to keep the pressure on with the defense, and I think they've got to try to put this one away early.
Now here's Thomas. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Pass to Smart from deep. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Greg, you were talking about Isaiah Thomas. He had no love lost for the Suns in their first meeting. He took them apart, Clark, on the floor. Remember that game? Stared them down as he was hitting shots. Looked at that bench, man. He had a big chip on his shoulder.
Yeah, and you know, most guys that are a little undersized and battle doubters all their careers bring that kind of edge anyway. You throw in the fact that he was disappointed how the trade unfolded. He was amped up and ready for that return visit.
Olynyk, and he's good on the three ball. Olynyk's got himself on the board with three there.
There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
To the paint. And there's the three-second violation.
Taking a look here at some numbers for Deion Waiters. How his last 10 games have gone. He's averaging about 7 points a game, 3 assists, and 2 rebounds. And you look at those numbers, not bad. But, guys, I think he can do better, and he knows it.
And he has high expectations for himself as well, guys. But he just hasn't delivered fully on his potential yet.
Now, here's Olynyk, and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
And the thing with Kelly Olynyk, he does some stuff that really helps you, and some also that will hurt. I mean, he's highly skilled. He's got the deep range, textbook positioning in terms of the post, a lot of tricky moves down there. Yet he has a hard time being effective against great athletes, which the NBA is filled with. So he's going to have to evolve as a basketball player if he wants to be effective.
And he identified the matchups where he can be effective because Clark is against explosive long wing guys. They'll take advantage of him.
Yeah, they will. But in the right matchup, he's effective. He can help you. He makes 35% of his threes, has done that for the last 2 years. And I think he gives you some toughness and rebounding as well. I like him as a second unit player.
Here's Smart following the score by Oklahoma City. That's good.
Almost an impossible shot to block in the post. The defender can't give up that much of a height advantage and expect to contest it.
Offensive rebound to the middle. Cantor kicks to Singler. Again, Oklahoma City.
That is some real serious dime dropping there. Exquisite assist.
Domination in the first quarter. It's been pretty lopsided. Thunder out in front, leading by 14. And we'll be back in just a moment with the start of the second quarter. You ain't really trying to get rich.
And Serge Ibaka, becoming known for his shooting ability now, he talked about the confidence his teammates and his coach instilled in him.
He trusts you. Every time he passes the ball, when you don't shoot, he screams you, shoot ball. Then next time what? You will shoot. And if he misses, he say, yeah, good shot. You know, and your coaches in the practice talking to your teammates. Man, when Serge is open, give him the ball. He will make that shot.
Well, if you wonder how much difference a coach can make for a player, there it is, huh?
You heard it in Serge's voice, too. That confidence has already been planted in him. That voice telling him, shoot the ball, is now in his own head. He's going to be just fine.
Welcome back, everyone, to Lopsided First Quarter in the books already as we start the second quarter. And a breakdown here, guys, the hustle stats for the Thunder.
And it's been about their defense. They're playing with a frenetic pace, putting a lot of pressure on the ball handlers and forcing turnovers.
Another big aspect of their game tonight has been the fast break, transition opportunity. They're really keeping it up-tempo so far.
On the court right now for the Celtics, Kevin Turner is out there with Brantley. Then it's Jay Crowder, and it's Amir Johnson, and it's Sellinger in at the five, roaming the paint. And that one's good. Morrow's got 10 points in the game.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agendas.
Yeah, and it's really fun to see that kind of unselfishness. Really hard not to appreciate all the assists they've racked up.
Oklahoma City leading by 14. From deep three-point range, the rebound by Johnson. Turner with it. Singler covering. Turner passes to Johnson. Back to Turner. It's stolen by Ibaka. Second quarter of basketball, just over a minute and a half played so far.
They're hovering around 50% for the game in three-pointers. That's pretty good. But they've really elevated here in the second quarter.
Now a timeout called by Boston. And guys, Serge Ibaka's production was just a little off last season. We're not talking, you know, big number changes. We're talking small dips in a number of categories.
Well, one category where he did really fall off, though, Kevin, was field goal percentage. A career 53% shooter, he dropped down to 47.
And getting back to Ibaka, everything changed for him the minute Kevin Durant was lost last season. I mean, defenses could focus on him, and he was the Thunder's only front court scoring threat. And as much as he's improved on offense, he still has neither the flexibility nor skill set to be a guy that can be considered a first or second option offensively.
Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Thank you, Kevin. Brad Stevens had some words for his team over the break. He told his guys that their offense needed to run through Sellinger. Coach is calling on him to play a big role in the offense for the rest of this game, to really be one of the key guys for them down the stretch. He also wants to see a patient offense, work for the shot, move the ball around, and as he told them, quote, if you don't see a good shot, find someone who does. I'm sure coach is hoping those changes turn the tide in this game and shrink the deficit before halftime. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, Doris, thank you very much. And no good on the technicals, so unable to pick that one up.
You know, talking about Ibaka, last season was good for his growth. I mean, he got a taste of what it's like to be the first or second scoring option rather than an afterthought. Now it's up to him to take that experience and convert it into improvement.
Crowder, the rebound by McGarry.
Good little two-man action there, but they just can't get the shot to fall.
Yeah, but that was a beauty. Good-looking shot, well-executed play. I wouldn't be surprised to see them go back to it.
Austin with the ball, following the score by Oklahoma City. Johnson kicks to Crowder. On the wing, Turner to the inside, and the shot's good from Crowder. Crowder's got 5 points now this quarter.
Here it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great position inside.
Yeah, just getting the ball into the post has to be option number one for them right now.
And stolen by Payne. To the inside. It's stolen by Sellinger. Outside Turner. Johnson sets the screen for Turner. It's Owinger with the drive. Here's McGarry. Deep two from Collison, and Oklahoma City again with the bucket.
And that's going to increase the field goal percentage even more. They are at a huge edge in that category.
And that's because they've been playing smart basketball. I mean, they've been very patient offensively, and their shot selection has been superb.
Johnson, good.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
And there's Ibaka. That's good on the assist by Westbrook. Westbrook's got 5 assists tonight.
Great outside shooting fueling this run.
And the D is getting bombarded. They haven't been able to slow them down the least bit. And now he's taken a solid opening in the quarter and built on it here in the second.
And the whistle blows on the backcourt violation. He went over and back.
Kevin, let's take a look at what the Oklahoma Thunder did over the last month in the league ranking. First in scoring, first in rebounding. And they're also number one getting into the passing lanes and coming up with steals. An aggressive team that ball hawks very effectively.
And you go back to their offense, the most explosive in the league. I mean, everyone talks about the great offense beating great defenses. And I tell you what, they make it difficult to hang with.
And watching Serge Ibaka, the intimidation factor is fierce, Mark, and it's been that way ever since he entered the NBA.
That's his game, Kevin. He's not the most physical shot blocker in the league, but boy, his anticipation and timing off the charts.
Here's Johnson, the Thunder making the shot. Left side, Bradley, just 5 on the clock. The jump, Collison. Three, and again, Oklahoma City with the triple.
Yeah, such a sweet 3-point stroke there, and it can really open things up inside because as good as he shoots it, it forces the opposing bigs to have to step out on the perimeter.
Now here's Turner. He's a good contributor to his team, averaging about 10.5 points a game. Shot from the wing. Again, Oklahoma City.
And the lead continues to increase. They are just playing flawless basketball at both ends.
Greg, I can't identify an area where this team has underperformed. I mean, they've been 5-star in every category.
Russell Westbrook. That's his first personal foul.
For Boston, they have gone 1 of 3 at the line here. He's off on the first, and a new group in for the Celtics. He hits the second from the line. Seconds left to play in the first half. The 15-footer, and the officials call a traveling violation. Westbrook against Thomas. Westbrook with the steal. So as we conclude the first half, so far fairly one-sided. Oklahoma City out in front, running away with it. Time now for the halftime break, with the third quarter soon to follow, right here on 2K Sports.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And hello again. We have amped up home crowd joining us for our halftime report. Ernie Johnson with the illustrious Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Oklahoma City has the edge here at halftime. They are completely in control of the game, leading by a massive amount. And let's go to Kenny. What'd you think of their first half?
Well, it has been an electric performance. These guys were firing on all cylinders. They came out aggressive, going after those rebounds, and they were piling it up. I think they wanted to send a message with their physicality, and they're going to be nearly impossible to stop if they're playing that way.
And Shaq, your thoughts on the Celtics?
Well, when you look at the opponent field goal percentage, that tells the whole story. They gave him way too many good looks. When they come out of the break, they got to play way tougher, Ernie. Get those hands up. Get in your opponent's face. Do something.
That's going to do it for now, as the second half is just about ready to get started. We'll see you later.
Welcome back, folks. Thank you for tuning in to the NBA on 2K Sports as we get set to get going once again. Hey, during the break, players getting a chance to refuel and hydrate with some Gatorade, as there is more basketball in store.
Take a look at what Morrow's been doing. 10 points, and he's knocked down a pair of three-pointers in this game, too.
And maybe it's time for them to set a few more screens for him up top and let him add to that total.
McGarry out there with Nick Collison. Then it's Payne, then it's Ibaka, and it's Westbrook in at the point guard position. That's the lineup in the game for Oklahoma City. Now here's Payne. Pulls it from 20. Good, and the assist goes to Collison. Payne's got his third basket of the night right there. Boston's gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc so far tonight. Outside Thomas. Johnson outside. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. It is now to Payne. From 13, Ibaka, the pass to Westbrook. Again, Oklahoma City.
How many times have we seen a possession take that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist totals, heck, they've been clearly the better team.
Now here's Crowder. 9 points in the game so far. To the left side wing. A shot by Sullinger, wide open. Off target from the wing.
And really a fantastic season for Sullinger last year. He made some leaps forward, but missed a lot of time still due to injuries. And really, these are some of the toughest calls an official has to make.
Yeah, but in this case, I think he got it right. I mean, the defender was still moving there and never really had good legal guarding position. He wasn't set.
Now, here is Ibaka. He's playing a pretty big role for him at the offensive end, averaging about 12.5 points a game. Sullinger did continue to improve last year, Clark, but you can't ignore that he had to miss time once again.
Yeah, and you hope that he'll be able to stay healthy for a full year at some point. When he's on the floor, he's a hard matchup for just about every team in the league.
The Celtics have hit just 2 free throws and 5 attempts today.
And really, the form at the line all season has been terrific, 79% as a team.
One of the things they've done, guys, is taken pride in their free throw shooting this season, and rightfully so.
And guys, as much as Isaiah Thomas can help you on offense, at times he can hurt you on the defensive side. Immediately posted up by whomever he's guarding, you have to give help. And of course, that leaves your defense vulnerable, particularly on the weak side and controlling that defensive backboard.
The Celtics making a switch here. Turner's checked in.
Perfect screen there. Set him up with a terrific look.
Yeah, I like the fact that the setup was good, the screen was solid, but you also have to look at the fact that Sender didn't do his job as well as he could have.
They are on fire right now. That's 4 straight makes.
And that's an intentional foul. Greg, you're talking about Isaiah Thomas before, certainly his short stance.
We need to calm down. We're taking too many shots early in the clock. Let's get some ball movement and run something on the offensive end. Keep it simple. Throw it down inside or run some pick and roll up top.
Timeout is called. First of the game for the Thunder.
Yeah, clearly they were starting to show signs of fatigue, so coach wanted to give them a second to get their win back.
Little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. He feeds it to Johnson. And stolen by Singler. Here's Adams in Oklahoma City again with the bucket.
And all of a sudden, you can see the confidence overflowing offensively.
Getting everything to dropping at an ideal time. I mean, they're poised for a terrific crunch time run here.
Some nice passing by Oklahoma City here. And that's going to be a travel.
A moment here to see some stats for Turner. He's really producing here second half of the season, averaging 12 points, 4 assists, and 5 rebounds. And this is the kind of strong, steady play you like to see. He's earning his keep and helping them win games.
And guys, they're finally getting the consistency they wanted to see from him. Look for that to continue.
Took the opportunity when he saw it. Bradley's got 5 now.
The screen play worked ideally there, and I'm not talking about the screen play you see in a movie theater. Gave him more than enough room to get that shot off.
And how about that for a response?
Well, it sounded as though, or at least it looked as though it sounded like, we'll give you a 3, and then we'll take it right back.
Tonight, averaging more than 22 points a game.
Smart to draw his man out to the perimeter. He's giving up too much size to be effective inside.
Showed nice basketball IQ. I agree, Greg. I mean, if he finds his spot on the perimeter and doesn't force it, I think his outside shot will be hard to block no matter who's defending
it. Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over.
And you know, the new court projection visuals, all the rage in the NBA now. Instead of having to use a screen over the court, they just project video and images straight onto the court. I think before long, you'll see it everywhere.
Making some changes. Kelly Olynyk checked in for Johnson. Jurebko comes in for Crowder. And Marcus Smart is subbed in for Avery Bradley. Here's 4. He's got 6. Those court projections you see in the pregame, we don't even have the best angle for them. They're so good.
Yeah, nice perk for those sitting a little higher up on those, or those watching TV. It's about putting on a show, and at the end of the day, entertaining the fans.
So it's the Celtics now. Thomas goes in. Thomas with another miss.
And listen, sometimes even the best of us are going to miss the easiest of opportunities.
He always knows where his teammate's going to be, and Kevin, that will let him put the ball where he wants it, right waiting for him.
Now here's Smart. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Here's Jurebko. The shot misses. So the Thunder will take it the other way. Passes to Adams. Singler outside. Hits it from three-point range. Singler's got 6 in the quarter.
And you can see he just caught a glimpse of the open man on the perimeter and immediately got him the basketball.
And Durant sends it back. And Olynyk kicks to Jurebko. Now Olynyk pass to Turner. Feeds to Jurebko. Shoots over Adams, and he's able to get it back. Clock at 4. Boston, no good that time either.
Major defensive lapse right there. He's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. You got to stay attached to him. They're lucky he couldn't punish them for it.
The Thunder shooting their first free throws of the game right now.
Okay, gentlemen, 2 shots. We could drive through the city, no doubt, but don't say my car. Say that news is out.
Newness, here's the anthem. Put your hand up that you with. Count your loot with. The first one falls. Celtics making a switch here. Sellinger's checked in. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. 27 seconds left in the third quarter. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
They got to find some, you're right. Here's Foy with the three from beyond the arc and then some. Foy's got 5 points now this quarter.
Having a lot of trouble stopping the three-point shot.
And they're not making up for it with their own shots from deep either, so that's a double-edged sword there.
Yeah, the offense seems completely in disarray.
Exactly. But at the other end, it's one bucket after the other. This run is getting out of hand right now.
And thanks again for joining us. Let's see what happens here in the fourth. And here are the Thunder now, and a look at the five for the Celtics to start the fourth quarter. We've got Kelly Olynyk. Young is out there with Yurebko, and it's Rozier in at the point. Now here's Adams. Deep two from Singler, and again it's Oklahoma City. Boston's gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. 2-on-1 as they jump out on the break. And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Trying to make it a three-point play. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Thunder.
Defensively, they played with a lot of energy, and the steals we've seen are a result of that aggressiveness.
They've repeatedly gotten out on the break tonight as well and scored a lot of baskets in transition. You look at Kevin Durant, and he does have a bit of an unusual body type. Still is fairly thin, even after 8 years in the league. Yet, up until last season, he'd been one of the more durable players in the league. Kind of like Reggie Miller in that regard.
And it's blocked.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Yeah, rebounding has been a big key in this one, Greg. They've asserted their will and have taken control on the glass.
Here's Rozier. Kevin Durant picking up that last basket to the left wing. Here's Olynyk. No good. They had a chance to end the run there.
Rare you'll see him miss such an open look.
And Kevin Durant again. Durant's got 7 now in this quarter.
They just can't miss. Everything they put up, it seems, goes in.
You know, sometimes you're the bug, and sometimes you're the windshield. They are certainly the bugs tonight. Nothing going their way.
And I'm not even sure that I'd want to be the windshield.
No, maybe the windshield wiper.
Yeah, right.
And so it's Boston with it, following the score by Oklahoma City. Olynyk dishes to Yurebko. Offline with his three.
Boy, even though he missed, you can't give up that kind of a look very often.
Better to be lucky than good sometimes. Fortunately, they didn't get burned on that one.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
And that's because the ball is looking for the best shot, and it's really paid off for them during the run.
Here's Cantor after the basket by Boston, and he gets it to go.
Boy, they are passing the ball very crisply right now.
They really are, and their last three buckets have come by way of an assist.
And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Cantor.
And you can tell that pass just hung in the air for a long time.
Yeah, exactly. Long enough for him to get a hand on it and knock it out of play.
Boston making some changes. Tyler Zeller comes in for Olynyk. And it's Johnson in for Yurebko. Zeller against Adams. Lock at 6. Fires from 14, and he hits the jump shot. 6 points for Johnson.
And Commissioner Silver taking a bold stance on sports betting. I mean, going in the last season, he wrote that op-ed piece saying that it needs to be legalized federally and basically brought into the light of day.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. And for Commissioner Silver arguing for legalized sports betting, that's a major reversal from what most sports commissioners Clark had said in the past.
Yeah, you know, I like his open-mindedness, not just about that issue, but a number of issues that confront the league. And, you know, he's right in regards to the gambling. With the internet, people are making these bets anyway, so it makes sense for the league to take a look at it.
Third minute of action now gone here in the fourth. From the wing, Roberson gets the bucket.
The shooting percentage continues to elevate here in the second half.
Well, as a group, they've been harmonic since the break. In sync. Good team basketball resulting in high-quality shots.
Thunder have gotten all eight of their shots in the fourth quarter to drop. Truly remarkable. Here's Waiters. Dishes to McGarry. Buries the long-range jumper.
And another triple to their second half total.
They came out of the break just dropping bombs and just are not letting up at all.
Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
And that's how you make a steal count. Turn it into a quick slam at the other end.
It was really a case. It looked like Greg Anthony right there, if I can say so. It was really a case of a great defensive play triggering some instant offense.
Yeah, I remember GA as an irritant. And this guy, much like Greg, creating havoc out there.
So it's the Thunder now, following the bucket by the Celtics. Roberson gets the bucket.
Well, he knew how many inches he had over the guy. I mean, let's face it, good decision to just rise up and take the jump shot.
Ball's knocked loose. Here's Moore. It's good. Now he's shooting 6 for 7.
I love his shot selection today. He set the bar for the rest of the team.
Rozier, the pass to Hunter. Here's Morrow again, Oklahoma City.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it, just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for the Thunder.
The blocking really turned things into their favor this time.
Well, Kevin, timing and
seem to come in fairly easy for these guys, and what's been a very strong year, to say the least. Tonight will push them up to 56 wins.
And by getting the hard-earned victory here this evening, they'll have snapped the 1-1 season series deadlock between these two teams, finishing 2-1 on the year against the Celtics.
A fantastic show. And what an amazing all-around game it was for Singler. Every inch of the floor was his tonight as he came out and injected an energy into every play.
So it's Boston now, after Oklahoma City gets the three. Doubled by Collison. And Young, here we go. Rejected by Collison. Here's Payne. Battles through traffic and lays it in.
That one will seal the deal there. They've exploded here at the end.
Boy, I love the serious killer instinct they've shown. Finishing strong.
Here's Rozier. Olynyk. No good, unable to end this run. 3-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Collison gets a wide open look, and the Thunder another three.
And just a terrific job of taking care of business in front of the home fans.
And Greg, those fans had a hand in the win. I mean, they gave this team a big lift throughout the game. I thought there was great energy in the building.
You other guys, as soon as the shot goes up, crash the glass.
Guys, your thoughts?
This is a timeout maybe just so they can pat each other on the back, because no other reason to call it.
Well, they're really just being conservative, making sure they don't make any last-minute mistakes, I guess. I mean, I have no idea. No idea.
Thank you. 20 seconds left in the game. Here's Rozier. The kick out to Young. Not enough on that one as it misses. Here's Foy with the three and the miss. So no problem for Oklahoma City as they get the win. This game may not have been the most exciting we've ever seen, but you have to appreciate just what a clinical performance they put on.
Yeah, they were the superior team in every department, in every category to me, Kevin. I know their fans loved it and appreciated it.
And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Well, Russell, how important was getting this win here at home following that road trip?
It was huge, man. Coming off a loss last night, a tough one. And it was a great win for us. Got back in front of our home crowd, and we played great.
Great job bouncing back, Russell. Thanks for your time, guys.
All right, Doris, thank you. And that about does it for the final game of the NBA regular season. This is Kevin Harlan saying thank you for watching. And this broadcast has not ended just yet, as we've got the award-winning Ernie Johnson standing by here for the postgame show.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Many thanks, Kevin. And now a chance to check out some of the tremendous play tonight from our Jordan player of the game. He notched his season high, and his scoring really seemed to set the tempo for his team tonight.
Man, he gave them a big boost, and they probably didn't even know it was coming. This guy provides such great depth. He's an option that can come through whenever they need him, and they really need him tonight to put a stop to the losing streak.
He was dead on from the field tonight, guys. I'd call his performance economical because there was no wasted opportunities. He took advantage of every good look he got. I mean, everything he put up was going in.
And that brings us to the end of our broadcast for this evening. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our illustrious 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson saying good night, and we'll see you again soon, but not soon enough.
I won't bow down to no man. Not even if I need to ride to the next village. Not if I need to cross country.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Tonight, it'll be the Chicago Bulls up against the Oklahoma City Thunder. And for Oklahoma City, they've been a very competitive team this season, more so than it might appear when you look at the standings and see they're 18 games back of the top spot. And for all those teams that have wrapped up playoff spots, Shaq, what can we expect from them strategically here at the end of the regular season?
Well, for the top team, Ernie, it becomes about securing home court advantage. You want to be peaking at the right time heading into the playoffs. We've seen a lot of teams, Ernie, start off strong. Where are they now?
Do you want rest if you're a frontline player, if you're a guy who's playing a lot? Do you need some rest before the playoffs?
You know, a lot of people answer that question, and if you play more than 8 years, yes, you need rest. If you're a young player, such as Freak, you don't need rest.
No, you may have players coming back from midseason injuries, but you need to get them back into the flow. But you got to get your playoff game face on. And you know who had the best game face playoff?
Alonzo Mourning?
No, this guy next to us. Like, show him your game face.
Alonzo had a good game face, too.
Stop it. You look at this guy's game. Look at this guy's game face. Show him.
Let me see your game face.
You know what, Kenny? I lost it. I can't do it.
Let me see your game face. That is frightening.
Oh, wait.
That's not a game foot. That's your game book look. I can't do it anymore.
Here's a guy with no game face, Kevin Harlan.
Alonzo Mourning.
It's a road game for the Thunder, and they're facing an interconference matchup in today's game. A time-honored tradition, the NBA on 2K Sports, Sunday Night Hoops action. Delighted to have all of you with us here tonight. This is Kevin Harlan to call the game with our analysts, Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. A look at Chicago. They can secure their spot in the postseason with the victory here.
Well, they played extremely well to get this win streak, Kevin, but right now they're in the midst of a game where it might not continue. The team they're facing wants to end the streak that they are on right now.
Yeah, and the longer the streak goes, the bigger the target on their back becomes. So especially now when they're facing a team as tough as this, that probably feels like it should be the one on the winning streak.
All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Taking a look at the Thunder. Now, know it's the international combo of Ibaka and Adams. Russell Westbrook out there with Roberson. And it's Durant in at the three spot. You go back to before last season with Durant. He was set to lead Team USA to the tournament, but had to withdraw from the team.
And, you know, withdrawing Kevin might have been the right play to keep him healthy. He still ended up on the shelf a good while last year, but I still think it was the right decision on his part.
Excellent ball movement there, guys.
And that's keyed this run. Passing it with purpose, the D hasn't been able to keep up.
Two open that time. Made it look too easy. Butler's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. Lafitte to Durant. Here's Roberson. The basket good off the assist from Durant.
Impressive start here. That's five straight makes to start the game.
Butler in the corner. Trains the three-pointer. Butler's got six.
A splendid pass that time by Rose.
And it's out of bounds. Oklahoma City able to retain possession.
You take a risk with those long passes. They're lucky the D couldn't collect it.
We're just about 2 minutes into the first quarter. For three, Westbrook. And again, Oklahoma City with the triple.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
Greg, you're exactly right. I mean, everything seems to be dropping. Impressive scoring here.
And a breakdown here, guys. The hustle stats for Oklahoma City.
They've come out in attack mode on the defensive end. They've applied pressure and forcing turnovers.
They've gotten their fair share of points off turnovers so far tonight, too.
defensively, that possession better not start a trend because they just handed him 2 points.
Again, Oklahoma City.
Wow, what a game for them so far. Very impressive. They haven't missed yet.
Bulls trail by 11. Gibson with the screen on Westbrook. And there's the foul. It goes on Serge Ibaka. That is his first foul of the game. First quarter to play. We're about 3 minutes in. And it's Butler missing.
And with room like that off the pick, you have got to knock that one down.
Well, you know, they did everything right, Greg. They executed. All you want is a good look at the basket. Sometimes the shots just don't fall.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while. And it's like raining buckets right now. I wonder if this is the early stages of a blowout.
Well, we got to be careful. Don't want to get ahead of ourselves just yet. But it has been pretty ugly so far, no doubt about that.
And that's some inspiration. Steals, blocks, and a big dunk. Those are ways that you can really change the momentum in a game.
Well, they got to chip away, Clark, at that deficit, and no doubt that'll help.
And that's what he's out there for, guys. I mean, he is an electrifying player, no doubt.
And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago. They're coming off that win against Philadelphia.
You know, they played well enough to win, but to be honest with you, I just felt like their opponent's defensive performance was shaky at best.
Yeah, I'd go along with that, Greg. I mean, the game wasn't handed to them, but they definitely didn't have to work as hard for it as they should have.
And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago. Their last encounter was in Oklahoma City, where they were able to handle the Thunder.
They were just locked, really, in a zone from a team defense standpoint, and nobody ever got stuck on an island. There was always somebody providing help, and the communication was tremendous.
And that was the key, Greg, the communication and the teamwork. You can't play good rotating defense if you're not communicating and on the same page. They were doing all of that at a high level.
And the Thunder going with a whole new group out there. Here is Rose. They count on his contributions, currently providing 16.5 points a game. Poked away. And the Thunder pushing it up now. Here's Payne. Takes it into the teeth of the D and converts the layup. Payne's got his first 2 points. Earlier, Doris Burke spoke with head coach Fred Hoiberg. What did you find out, DB?
Our focus was on the difficulty of slowing down this dynamite offense, something they've had some success with when they won the first two matchups of the season. He told me, we've been able to find some defensive wrinkles to catch them off guard. But more than anything, it's all about our players' hard work and commitment defensively. They've embraced the challenge. Let's see if they can sustain that great defensive effort tonight.
All right, Doris, they're probably well aware of the firepower they're up against
it. You know, it sounds like it. I mean, their coach knows how tough it is to slow this team down, and he wants to make sure his guys understand that as well.
Yeah, I guarantee he got his point across when prepping them for this one. He focused clearly on their absolute toughest effort defensively. They're relying on their three-point shooting and getting pretty good results right now.
You're right. Three of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
Here's Dunleavy. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Gasol, no good.
And being that close to the hoop, I thought he had enough room to finish that one.
To the left wing for three, Dunleavy. It's hauled in by Collison. The Thunder leading by 23. Here's Waiters. And again, it's Oklahoma City.
You could not diagram a better way to open a quarter.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, look at the lead they've jumped out to already. What a start.
Well, with Steve Kerr and Jason Kidd both coming with no coaching experience over the last few seasons and also having success, I don't know, guys. Maybe we should throw our hat in the ring. But pretty impressive stuff.
That's not for me to do. I've already determined I don't want to coach for a paycheck, even if it is a big one.
And the basket good.
Four of their last five makes came off of a high-quality shot inside.
Textbook. Really, when you look at how they're playing, they are having their way down low.
And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
How about the excitement right now that he's playing the game with? I love it.
He capped that dunk off with some serious hang time on the rim.
I tell you what, he just couldn't contain himself on that one.
You know, you look at the coaching success for both Jason Kidd and Steve Kerr, both with long playing careers, championship experience on their resumes. Steve, in fact, even had some time in the front office with Phoenix.
And don't forget about his broadcasting career either, Kevin. I mean, I think in both cases, though, you look at these two guys, they were able to come in and have immediate credibility with their teams and their playing experience, part of their preparation for being coaches.
Rose passes to Butler. Shot is off. And it's Oklahoma City the other way. And moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Warriors.
Yeah, and really lucky that they weren't blown out in that game because I just thought the effort was lacking.
They just couldn't hit on anything that worked for them, no matter what approach they used.
From deep. Raiders no luck. Bulls trail by 21. Rose kicks to Gasol. No one near him. Yes, and it's Rose with the assist that time. Rose has got his fourth assist in this one. Here's Waiters. Shot goes down. Very quick possession right there. Waiters got nine.
Boy, they are passing the ball very crisply right now.
They really are, and their last three buckets have come by way of an assist.
They can't guard us on the perimeter. Spread the floor and isolate up top. Spacing, fellas. Spacing.
An almost entirely new group here. Joakim Noah, he's checked in for Gasol. Miritich comes in for Taj Gibson. Doug McDermott, he's checked in for Dunleavy. And Brooks subbed in for Derrick Rose. Butler kicks it to Noah. Singler brings the double team, and that's a foul called on Kyle Singler. That is his first foul of the game. McDermott kicks to Brooks. Just five to shoot. Miritich has a wide open look. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Brooks. Miritich has got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. Nikola Miritich, drafted as a late first rounder, Clark, back in 2011. The Spanish star finally made his rookie debut in the NBA last season, and It was worth the wait.
It sure was, Kevin. I mean, once he started to get consistent PT, I mean, he was remarkable. Can run like the wind for a big guy. Not that strong, but he's more aggressive than you think.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, if they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm looks.
And to battle back, they've got to shore up the defense. I mean, there's no other way to come back from a deficit unless you play good defense. Boy, and for Randy Foy, I thought it was a big bounce-back year for him last season. His points per game were the highest they've been in 5 years, and his field goal percentage was the highest it's been in 5 years as well.
Talking about Randy Foy last year, one difference is that he started almost every game, 78 the most in his career. That may have given him, Greg, additional confidence. Who knows?
You know, well, where I was impressed, Kevin, with his improvement was as a facilitator and rebounder. He seemed to lose his mojo for a few years in there, but last season, I really feel like he got it back.
And finished off by Miritich.
Fellas, that two-hand monster slam was vicious.
I don't think there was anyone, and I mean anyone, that could have stopped him on that one.
I tell you what, I'm glad they didn't try, because somebody might have got their feelings hurt.
Chicago's gone 3-5 from three-point land so far in the ballgame. Launches it. That one goes in for him, too, making it look easy. He's now 4-for-4.
He has been fantastic this quarter, guys. It's just the kind of effort they need if they're going to continue to trim the lead.
And that one's good. Durant.
And they are shooting the lights out
from distance here early.
How do you stop this? I mean, it seems like they can't miss.
And he gets it to go. And that's 10 points for Jimmy Butler.
And, you know, he's enjoyed the kind of day you expect in terms of shooting the basketball. He can bring them right back into this game.
And Oklahoma City again with the bucket. 1:32 left in the first quarter. Brooks dishes to Noah. And the shot's good after hitting off the rim. The Thunder leading by 20. Singler with it. Now defended by McDermott. The wide open look for Durant. And that's going to be a travel. As we close in on the start of the playoffs, let's see how the West is stacking up. We take a look at the Warriors. Very strong season they've had, always at or near the top of the conference. And right now they're in first place in contention for that. Exactly where they want to be as they close in on the postseason. And, of course, Oklahoma City, they're in third place.
And when I look at Oklahoma City, they must have reached every goal they set for themselves this season. For them to be this high in the standings this late in the season, what an accomplishment.
And I know it took a long time for people around the league to trust their success, but I don't think there's anybody left out there who doesn't think they're for real at this point.
Morris checked in for Chicago. Brooks and Durant sends it back. Ibaka had the pass to four. Goes up on the high post. The basket good off the assist from Durant. Durant's got his third assist on the night. And Randy Foy gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. Portis, he's checked in for Doug McDermott.
Bobby Portis.
Brooks outside. Portis, the pass to Brooks. Second chance shot, and it's good on the layup. Moore's got his first points of the game.
His hard work on the backboard really just has given them more opportunities to score.
Here's Ibaka. No good. Great defense that time from Noah. Brooks against Singler.
Thunder five.
Chicago shooting their first shots from the stripe in this game.
Aaron Brooks at the line for the Bulls. Two shots.
All right, now. Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good. Free throw is good for Brooks. Outside Durant. Three-pointer. And he gets it to go. Durant's got his third basket of the night right there.
And really, that's what built the early lead here. Killer shooting from beyond.
And the defense needs to recognize that and get to the shooters. It's imperative that they get a hand up.
And the Gasol brothers, both starters in the All-Star game last season. It's the first time that's happened in NBA history. Powell talked about the joy of sharing the NBA stage with his brother Mark. Well, their story is a bit like a fairy tale, the way two of them, sons of medical professionals in Spain, have become two of the best centers in the NBA of this era.
Yeah, and especially, Kevin, when you remember what a raw talent and how big and bulky Mark Gasol was when he was drafted by the Lakers, who traded him to Memphis for his brother.
Welcome back, folks. We'll see if we're in store for a more tightly contested quarter as we move here into the second. And a very convincing performance from the Thunder so far.
I just think that from an intensity standpoint, their defense has really been the key. It's been the catalyst as they've been able to disrupt their opponent's offense.
Absolutely. I mean, they've been much more intense defensively.
And their defense not only has been intense, but it's been swarming and saran wrap-like.
Portis is out there with Pau Gasol. Then there's Etuan Moore. Then it's Rose. And it's Dunleavy in at the small four. So that's the five in the game for Chicago. Both free throws good from Gasol.
Pau Gasol was the number three pick back in 2001. He managed to average 18-9 his first season, was rookie of the year, became a perennial all-star. There's no way his younger brother Mark, who was a second-round pick, could ever match up to that, right? Not so fast, people. Mark's pretty good, too.
Talking about Pau and brother Mark, both of them were excellent last season. The difference is that Pau has always been considered a great prospect, so detractors are much harder on him when they see cracks, I think, Greg, in his game.
Yeah, you know, for Marc Gasol, it can only exceed expectations because they started out so low. I'd simply say that if I had to pick between one or the other for best career, I'd do everything I could to pick both.
Good way to get out of it. Good answer. The Bulls have been good at the line so far, 5 of 5.
And typically, a strength of theirs, 79% on the season.
Okay, that's been one of the strongest aspects of this team this season. I mean, there have been very few off nights for them at the free throw line.
He misses the free throw.
And they're getting to the line a lot in this quarter, guys, and it hasn't been by accident.
Yeah, I don't think it's an accident that aggressiveness correlates with playing better. So the aggressiveness is starting to pay off.
So he comes up empty, missing both.
And for all the flash and dash in Oklahoma City over the past few years, Serge Ibaka silently goes about his business. While all eyes are on the megastars, Durant and Westbrook, Ibaka lurks around like a jaguar. I mean, finding opportunities to exploit any weakness in the opposition.
McGarry with the block.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
And it's been a well-rounded performance. I mean, strong rebounding has certainly been at the center of it, but it's been good on a number of levels.
Talking about Ibaka, he does so many things that help his team. The little things that always make a difference, even with his superb free throw shooting, up to a remarkable Clark 84% last year.
Yeah, but, you know, Ibaka had an injury of his own. As much as people talked about Durant's injury, the knee soreness Ibaka had cost him 18 games last year, so that was tough for him.
With the steal. Second quarter of play with around 2 minutes gone so far. Rose, good.
And that's definitely a shot that he has in his arsenal.
The Thunder leading by 19 points. And good on the basket. Book it. Foy's got 5 points now this quarter.
The defense is far too slow to close out on those three-point attempts.
And those triples, they sure do add up quickly, don't they? I mean, they've got to make some kind of adjustment here.
And the next one puts them in the bonus.
Yep, they'll be trying to draw that next foul quickly so they can start getting those easy chances at the strike.
Here's what Chicago's going with right now. Taj Gibson's checked in for Portis, and it's Jimmy Butler coming in for Etuan Moore.
Yeah, that one put them over the limit, and if they're not careful, this could turn into a parade at the free throw line.
The Bulls have had 7 opportunities at the free throw line and made good on 5 of them. The first free throw is good.
Derrick Rose possesses a great skill set, ball handling, passing, and understanding of how to score. First rookie to ever win the All-Star Weekend Skills Challenge.
And Rose drops them both. Getting back to Rose, it's his extraordinary handle that allows him to get anywhere on the floor. Such confidence in the way he dribbles and drives, whether it's getting up in a position to set up a teammate, take it himself. He's the one very best at controlling that ball.
It's a great point. I mean, guys like D. Rose, Chris Paul, Steph Curry, Kyrie, they all have maximized that skill. I mean, the thing that separates him and puts him in that
Russell Westbrook category is the pure physical strength when healthy he's able to play with.
I don't want us to take shots with hands in our faces. Move the ball. Move the ball. Spread their defense and get our shooters some clean looks. Tighten up. Calm down. We're taking too many shots early in the clock. Let's get some ball movement and run something on the offensive end. It's simple. Let's throw it down inside or run some pick and roll.
You might as well make those adjustments right away.
And the first one at the line is good.
And there was a question of whether or not Derrick Rose would be able to get back to his former self. At times last season, you could see him back in that MVP form.
And Rose drops them both.
That's a great job getting to the line here. You know, he didn't have a single attempt in that first quarter because I thought he was tentative. Much more aggressive here in the second.
And sometimes we all just want to show people that we have the range.
Yeah, you speaking from experience? We already know how good his range is. He shouldn't be firing from that deep.
Mm-hmm. And they've got to talk to each other on D. There's miscommunication, and now he's able to make them pay.
You know, one aspect of their play today that's really been tight and far superior is their passing.
And that kind of flow can be elusive. But the great offenses have it, and that's just what they've shown here tonight.
Kiwi Steven Adams, one of the toughest players down on the block.
And Kevin Adams is not afraid to get under somebody's skin. He's pretty strong defensively, too.
Chicago calls timeout.
And, you know, guys, that's one of the things I like about Adams. I mean, he'll draw the ire of opposing players just because of how he approaches the game.
Oklahoma City. Down low, here's Gasol. It's in, and he's a very efficient 5-for-6 on the game.
Yeah, and guys, Adams doesn't want to be known as a dirty player. I think he feels he plays aggressive and he hustles. And that sometimes rubs players the wrong way.
Bulls trail by 20. Butler on the wing. The layup missed.
+8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative. They've played, I think, with more purpose so far.
Here's Rose. after Oklahoma City gets the three. 14 points for Pau Gasol.
The number of points they've scored in the paint already today is pretty eye-opening.
It really is, Clark. The defenders need to do a better job of closing those lanes to the hoop.
Butler kicks to Rose. Pass to Gibson. Inside. Powered down with both hands.
Give credit where credit is due right there. A terrific assist.
The Thunder leading by 19 points. Passes it to Roberson. Let's it go from 11. Again, Oklahoma City.
Wow, risky shot there size-wise, but the incredible skill that he possesses allows that one to go.
Well, the quick high release negated any height disadvantage he had right there.
Now here's Gasol. 14 points for him. To the middle. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. Butler's got 3 assists tonight.
And they're beginning to just flat-out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's 4 straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point-blank range. Can't happen.
Wow, the floor just really opened up for him on that possession.
Yeah, I mean, I'm all for good offense, but that was just a terrible reaction from the defense.
And watching Nick Collison, he makes all the hustle plays, all the little plays, the things that really will not show up in a score sheet, stat sheet. For over a decade, he's had that role and embraced it.
And Kevin, the other thing he does as a veteran is a coach knows what he's going to get. He doesn't make the mistakes that some players make. And while he's not going to be a great scorer in the post or a high-flying rim protector, this game really is built on intelligence and toughness. And so positioning for charges, making open mid-range jump shots, all the unsung things that help a team win games.
Here's Gibson following the basket by Russell Westbrook. And Dunleavy gets it to go in.
And he has really come to life here after a slow start in that first quarter.
And right away, they match it with a 3-pointer of their own. Roberson's got 5 points now in the quarter. Tipped away. 4-on-3 as they bring it up. But they get it back. Morrow, that's a 2-pointer. And there's another one for the Thunder.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
Just beautiful when they play the game like this.
Now here's Gibson. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. That is good. 18 points for Pau Gasol.
Just couldn't get a hand in the face on that one.
That's using what you got. He's got a height advantage, put it to good use there, and got himself a clean look.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. So many people overlooked Pau Gasol prior to last season seemed to think that, Clark, he was past his prime.
Well, he was a starter in the All-Star game and a huge reason the Bulls played as well as they did. It was a big season for him. A lot of GMs shaking their head for not going harder after him.
Here's what Chicago's going with right now. Joakim Noah has checked in for Gasol. Miritich comes in for Taj Gibson. And it's Doug McDermott in for Dunleavy. And a new group in here for the Thunder. Serge Ibaka has checked in for Collison. Durant comes in for Roberson. Singler, he's checked in for Russell Westbrook. And it's Payne in for Anthony Morrow.
You know, and with Pau Gasol, it was weird to think that the Lakers were just so ready to let him go and move on. Almost an impossible shot to block in the post. The defender can't give up that much of a height advantage and expect to contest it. And we always talk about making your teammate better. That assist was right on target. And with the skill set that Powell has and the year he had, there's no telling how long he can play at a high level. Again, one of those guys that never been reliant on the athletic ability to have an impact.
Here's McDermott, following the score by Serge Ibaka. Nice shot by McDermott.
Timeout calls for the Thunder.
All right, man, let's get up!
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City.
And guys, what a strange rookie campaign for Dougie McBuckets. I mean, he entered the draft as a polished sharpshooter. The Bulls traded up in the first round to get him. And he ended up playing 9 minutes a game over the course of last season.
On the topic of Doug McDermott, one of the most decorated college players in recent history. And, Clark, you called a lot of his games.
Yeah, enjoyed watching him play, and I still think he has a bright future. Just never found any real rhythm. averaged only 3 points a game, but he didn't get much playing time. So look for him to bounce back in years going forward.
Now we get a chance to check out Kevin Durant. A wonderful string of games he's put together here lately. Tops in scoring. And he's among the top 20 free throw shooters in the league. Doesn't waste many opportunities at the line.
And I tell you what, his scoring abilities are almost otherworldly. I mean, no one's been able to slow him down or even come close.
First free throw is good. And so he makes both from the line. The Thunder leading by 21. Adams dishes the paint. Ibaka outside. Singler passes to Durant. Oklahoma City moving it around. From deep three-point range. Offensive rebound. Brooks against Durant. Takes the three. It's hauled in by Adams. Adams has got his third rebound on the night.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Guys, that's putting it mildly. I mean, they've been absolutely dominant.
And really, no choice but to lunge for that pass to make sure it didn't get through.
Yeah, and that was important. Probably would have been a quick 2 points if he doesn't get a hand on it and knock it out of bounds.
They're going to turn it over. They couldn't get it in bounds that time.
We've just seen them make mistakes on back-to-back trips. But those turnovers could have been avoided. Careless mistakes.
Absolutely. They have got to get a tighter handle on the ball.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. Bulls trail by 21. Poked away. Now here's McDermott. Tight defense on him. And pushing it up here. Here is Oklahoma City.
I think that play sort of sums up what we've seen throughout. Just simply being outplayed both sides of the ball. Smart basketball defensively turning into quick points.
And that can't continue. I mean, if they hope to get back in this game, I mean, it's really deflating from a morale standpoint. They need stops and points, not turnovers.
Beautiful finger roll to cap the head drive off. He knows how to finish with some flair and flavor, guys.
Brooks against Kanter, and Andre Roberson is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line.
Shooting two.
And that one falls for Brooks. And both free throws good for Brooks. And so it's Oklahoma City with it. Earlier in the game, they held a 25-point lead.
Oh, my goodness. That's like temporary insanity right there.
Do you think he realizes we've actually got a game, a serious game taking place here? I have my doubts, partner.
and he was camped in the lane there, and he gets the three-second call.
Yeah, big blunder there, and that could really cost him.
Yeah, and the timing of it was bad, too. I mean, they're trying to cut down and cut into the lead. Just a tough, bad break there.
Justin Holliday's checked in for Butler. Brooks with it, and it's Waiters picking him up. Back to Brooks. Here's the three. That's good. Brooks has got 5 points now this quarter.
That's the kind of D that you're not going to find success with, guys. They've got to get a hand in the face.
The three from Morrow. Joakim Noah grabs the miss.
Well, not really his best quarter as far as scoring. Let's see if he can eventually get back on track.
McGarry with the steal. Oh, and a fast break for Oklahoma City. Morrow leading the charge.
And really, once he got that steal, just really nothing the defense could do.
That's why turnovers are so costly, because in many cases, they're indefensible once possession changes hands.
The shot by Holliday, no good. Raiders no luck. Brooks kicks to Holliday. Back to Brooks. Bulls moving the ball around. Another miss by Holliday. Oklahoma City leading by 18. Morrow nails it from the high post. Morrow's got 13 points.
You know, he's putting on an outstanding offensive display, and he may just be getting warmed up here.
Holliday goes in, and that one is stuck right through.
That is really poor defensive awareness. I mean, he's one guy you don't want to give any space to. You've got to stay attached and connected.
It just seems like the more he touches it, the more the lead grows.
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock, and Brooks gets it to go.
And just a step ahead of the D in that possession there, making the pass, nice assist.
Here's Waiters, and again it's Oklahoma City.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
Waiters against Brooks, and the foul is called. He intentionally grabbed him there for some reason, I don't know.
Kevin, all I can think of is that he's trying to slow the game down a little bit.
Right.
That's a stretch, though. Definitely a strange move on his part. I mean, you know, obviously, there's some things out there he does not like and wants to talk it over.
Well, Greg, you play, and you envision yourself as a coach as well. So, you know, sometimes you need to make some adjustments.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over.
Shooting two. Shooting two.
That one is off. No good on the second free throw. Here's Cantor. His first shot coming late. It's tipped. So as we conclude the first half, so far fairly one-sided. It's the Thunder just dominating this one. And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Kevin, I have Derrick Rose. And, Derrick, you guys were scoring pretty nicely as a unit here tonight. How do you facilitate that?
Just be more efficient. I'm taking less shots, making sure that I make my shots and take my time on the offensive end and get people involved in the game.
Thank you, Derrick. Kevin, back to you.
All right, Doris, thank you. And stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter underway.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome, everyone. We'll be taking a look back at what was clearly a one-sided first half of action. Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Oklahoma City has the edge here at halftime. They are completely in control of the game, leading by a massive amount. Kenny, what do you think?
That was the half of the super sub for them. A lot of offense coming off the bench, and that's such a luxury to have that kind of firepower available. There were times when the pace picked up when the second unit came into the game, and that's the best part, having a bunch of guys who's ready at the drop of a hat.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Chicago?
They're getting completely outworked on the glass. Giving up that many rebounds is how you dig yourself into a hole like this, Ernie. They want to close the gap on the scoreboard. They got to close the gap on the boards. You like that, Ernie? They want to close the gap on the scoreboard. They got to close the gap on the boards. Oh, I'm so good.
Just about time for the third quarter to get underway, and we'll see you again at the horn.
Welcome back, everybody. Third quarter just about to get going here in what has been so far a runaway game.
What a game for Waiters. 18 points, and he's done a little bit of work behind the arc. He's got a pair of three-pointers.
And you know what? The defenders have that in the back of their minds now. They'll be on him a little tighter.
And on the floor for Billy Donovan as we get into the second half. Durant the three and Ibaka the four. Roberson is out there with Russell Westbrook. And it's Adams in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That'll be a five-second call.
Here we can get a look at Oklahoma City, Kevin, and what kind of numbers they put up these last 10 games. Third in rebounding, third in second chance points, and they also show up as a team in the top five in scoring. Boy, this team is balanced and versatile offensively.
And you look at their ferocious rebounding. They're imposing their will, and you can see the results. Their physicality is yielding tremendous dividends.
They're going to turn it over. They couldn't get it in bounds that time. And with this quick break, we can show you the list of the most explosive shooting guards in the NBA so far. Jimmy Butler, fourth.
And night after night, we see this group punish opposing defenses. I mean, if you pick one way to deal with them, they'll beat you another way.
Yeah, you don't have to take a long look at their point totals to see that this is the premier group of scorers at the premier scoring position in the NBA. Shooting guards can flat out bring it. And for Jimmy Butler, so much improvement over his young career, especially as a shooter. His rookie year, he shot just 18% from three. Last season, he shot 38% from there.
Shots good by Ibaka. Bulls trail by 18. Down low, here's Gasol. Yes, and it's Rose with the assist that time. Rose has got assist number 11 for him here tonight. Gasol with the steal. Right side, Butler got a piece of it. Here's Rose. It's hauled in by Adams. Adams has got his fourth rebound in this one. Westbrook drives in. Took him no time at all on that one. Westbrook's got 14.
And really, it looks like he may just try to take this thing over on his own and really build that lead up.
Really good awareness right there on the assist. Mike
Dunleavy. The Thunder leading by 15. Ibaka outside. Here's Adams. Again, the Thunder score.
Nothing but money for him to start the half. They've made all three of their shot attempts.
To the middle. Here's Gibson. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Earlier in the game, they held a 25-point lead. And here we go, the Bulls, fast break. They grabbed their own miss.
And how many extra possessions have they gotten because of that rebounding edge?
Well, it's been a bunch, and I think it's made the difference in the game. I mean, they've actually done a great job on the board.
Right around 3 minutes into the second half. Bulls trail by 20. Chicago calls timeout. Catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, I was able to listen in on what the head coach of the Chicago Bulls was going over in his huddle. He told Gasol that he wants their offense to run through him. Coach has a lot of faith in him offensively and let his players know it, insisting that he be at the forefront of what they do at that end of the court from here on out. Coach was not wasting any time in altering their strategy here in the second half, and Kevin, he's going to have to hope those changes take effect quickly.
All right, Doris. Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over.
They've been committing a lot of turnovers, and I imagine that's exactly what they're talking about right now. They need to tighten it up.
Here's Butler. He's got 14. Rose dishes to Gasol. Second shot opportunity, and it's Butler missing.
Physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. That plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Yeah, not to mention what it says on the scoreboard. They're really pushing them around. Straight bully ball.
Here's Rose. The Thunder making the shot. Kicks to Dunley. And it's blocked. Here's Collison, and again it's Oklahoma City.
And chalk up a few more points for him there. This has been a one-sided game in just about every area.
Absolutely. I echo that sentiment. Their offense, their defense, I mean, it's all been terrific. You know what? That's what you like to see. A perfect pass leading him right into the shot. Didn't even have to break stride.
Payne's shot is good. Assisted by Nick Collison. Rose with the ball. 15 points in the game. The game is checked in for Chicago. Butler attacking. This one for three. That's good from McDermott on the assist by Butler. Butler's got assist number 5 here tonight.
Oh, man, how about the last-minute decision there to pull the shot down and get a better one for your teammate? And how about that, responding to the three-pointer against them with a quick one of their own?
Terrific little tay-to-tay going on right now. Back and forth. Here we go.
And Randy Foy gets the whistle that time.
And that fourth foul, guys, might force him to scale back the aggression from a defensive standpoint. He does not need, nor does the team need, number 5.
And so here's Chicago. And counting, the shot is good. He'll go to the free throw line.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you've got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
Quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Thunder.
Fantastic passing. We saw it in the first half, and it's carried over here in the second.
They haven't wasted time getting the ball up the court tonight either, and it's resulted in a lot of fast break points.
That's good.
Great opportunity right there. He's got such tremendous length. He can just rise up and get separation for the three.
Gasol goes in. Rejected by Collison. But they'll get another chance. Chicago's gone 2 of 2 from long range in the third quarter so far. Another shot, and it's McDermott laying it in. McDermott's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Now that's where you like your shots to come from.
And Oklahoma City again with the bucket.
And his stroke has been dead on from the outside. I mean, inside, outside, it just doesn't matter.
To the paint, here's Singler. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a 3-point play. Bulls making a switch here. Moore's checked in. And a new group getting ready for Oklahoma City. Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for Collison. Durant comes in for Anthony Morrow. Deion Waiters checked in for Randy Foy. And Russell Westbrook is subbed in for Payne. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Westbrook. Steven Adams, he's checked in for Singler.
Steven Adams.
And it's Deion Waiters with the foul.
Deion Waiters. That's his third personal foul.
And it's Moore penetrating, and he converts the layup. Moore's got his second bucket of the night. Oklahoma City's gotten 12 of their points from long range in the third quarter, going 4 of 5 shooting. Shots good by Waiters.
They are wreaking havoc on them with the three-point shot here.
The defense has no answer right now. Even when they've gotten a hand up, it has not seemed to matter.
And guys, Deion Waiters is a man who has never met a shot he didn't like. Despite shooting less than 40% from the field last season, he just kept on shooting. Now, every once in a while, he'd get hot, and it would look good. But when he's off, which was most of the time, it didn't look very good. He's got to improve shot selection and shot discipline.
Chicago has gone 2 of 2 from long range in the third quarter so far. Rose goes in, and it's blocked by Adams. He feeds it to Waiters. It's deflected. Stolen by Rose. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. Dishes to Gasol. Gasol setting the pick for Butler. A wide open look for Gasol. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. Butler's got 6 assists now in the game. They get back to Waiters. There's a reason the Cavaliers dealt the former 4th overall pick in the draft. Not only did he shoot poorly, but Clark, he averaged less than 2 assists a game.
Yeah, I think it's a mindset adjustment with Waiters. I've loved his talent and his ability to make plays and shots. Now he just has to recalibrate his thinking so he can be effective in the role he's asked to play.
And they get it back. And he's good on the 3-ball. Waiters got 28 points for the game.
He's putting on a commanding performance here. He's hit 2 3-pointers in each half now.
Rose. And again, no good by Chicago.
He's going to play his way right onto the bench and out of the game if he continues to shoot it like he has so far in this quarter.
And you can see the difference with their ability to win with their speed, guys.
Boy, I love the pace and flow that their open court offense has been played with. I mean, it's been humming quietly, but very efficient.
Shoots from the baseline, and it's blocked by Ibaka, and he gets it back. Here's Moore, and he sinks that one in the back of the rim on the way in. Moore's got 6 points.
They have a little extra mojo going here, a little extra pep in their step, more hustle in this second half. They're doing a much better job in terms of second chance points.
Add another triple to their second half total.
They came out of the break just dropping bombs and just are not letting up at all.
That's good. And that's 17 points for Rose.
And really, the defense didn't do a lot to fight around that screen on that possession.
Waiters. No luck. Some solid defense from Butler. And it's Rose penetrating. McDermott passes to Moore. 7-foot shot. And it's Chicago scoring again.
So far, going for more of an inside game here in the second half. And I like that. A little smash-mouth basketball, taking it inside. I like the way he's not forcing anything, taking advantage of what the defense has given him. He's been a key contributor for them in this quarter.
Now here's Rose. He's got 17. And it'll be his 4th time going to the free throw line in the game.
Derrick Rose at the line for the Bulls. 2 shots.
Okay, gentlemen, 2 shots. 2 shots.
The first one falls.
What a game for Rose. 18 points, and what a game he's had passing the ball, too.
I love the fact that he plays for his teammates, really spreading the ball around, getting everyone involved.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Joakim Noah's checked in for Gasol. Portis comes in for McDermott. Miritich is checked in for Jimmy Butler. And Justin Holiday is subbed in for Etuan Moore. .152 left to play in the third. Stolen away. Miritich against Waiters. From downtown. Offensive rebound.
Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
And that one's good. McGarry.
And an open path to the hoop there. Easy bucket. We've seen that far too many times today.
Rose kicks it to Noah. No one near him. Shot no good. And it's Oklahoma City the other way. Here's Waiters again. Oklahoma City.
As hot as he's been this quarter, the game plan is simple, folks. Get him the ball and get out of the way.
And it's Rose penetrating in for his seventh make in 13 tries.
Really, really good at recognizing the gaps and getting the ball to the rim.
Cantor's shot is off.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
Rose passes to Portis, but he recovers it. And pushing it up here. Here is Oklahoma City. Shots good by Waiters.
And they're really in a good position here, thanks in part to the way he's been able to score the basketball.
Rose dishes to Noah. Rose gets a wide open look. Good, and a nice assist from Noah. And that's 23 points for Derrick Rose. And that's going to be a turnover. They called for 8 seconds. Yeah. 9 seconds left to play in the third. To the wing right side. Miritich drills it from outside. Miritich has got 13 points.
Nikola Miritich.
Payne. The shot misses. And as we conclude the third quarter, pretty much a blowout. It's been a one-sided affair. It's the Thunder opening up a huge gap. And we're just moments away from the start of the fourth quarter. Stay with us. And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. Turn it over. They couldn't get it inbounds that time.
Well, I tell you what, after turning the ball over so much in the first half, guys, he's really settled down nicely since and doesn't have any turnover since the break.
Out to Brooks. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. The shot by Holiday, no good. And here we go with Morrow running it up the court. The big man are Gibson and Noah. Then it's Brooks. Then there's Nikola Miritich. And it's Holiday in at the two spot. That's the five out there for the Bulls. Now here is Holiday. Launches a three. And Brooks gets it on the assist from Gibson. 12 points for Aaron Brooks.
That's two straight quick three-pointers they've allowed.
Defense just not reacting with enough aggressiveness.
And the basket by Morrow. Chicago's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. The drive by Brooks, that's good.
Not fazed at all by having a bigger defender on him down low. And I really thought he...
That particular situation, but, boy, I tell you what, he didn't look like he was out of his element at all right there.
And it's the Bulls with the ball, following the score by Oklahoma City. Noah kicks to Holiday. Good, and a nice assist from Noah. Noah's got his third assist on the night.
Most any NBA player can make you pay when you leave him that wide open. That's why you have to stay alert on defense. You know, when he gets rolling, guys, he can be an absolute handful to have to deal with. And right now, he is rolling strong.
Here's Payne. Again, the Thunder score.
You know, guys, fast break points right now in their favor, and they're really pushing the tempo.
And, Greg, defensively, you got to have better floor balance.
and commitment to hustling back. I mean, you got to sprint back. Good job back.
The Thunder have gotten every shot they've taken so far in the fourth quarter to go in. That's five in a row to start the quarter.
Talk about complete control. Everything working in this one for Collison.
He's got 11 points,
and he's come away with two steals as well. He's blown up some plays out there.
And it also shows you the importance of intelligence as a defender, because he has been a nightmare on the ball.
Two shots.
He misses the free throw.
You know, it hasn't always been the case in the NBA, but parity is at a great spot right now. Every team can compete for a title or end up last in their conference, it seems. It's something the NBA wanted and ultimately now has achieved.
Bulls making a switch here. Moore's checked in, so neither attempt will fall that time for him. And speaking of NBA parity, it's impossible to go from last to first in a single year, but it can happen in a three-year span.
And that's all you really want from a fan's perspective. Hope. To illustrate the parity, all four teams in the conference finals from last year were different from the year before.
Now here's Payne, and count it from 19 feet away. Chicago's gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. Moore outside. At the top of the key, Brooks. Thunder with the rebound. Collison's got his third rebound tonight. And Oklahoma City again with the bucket.
And the lead's not getting any smaller. Just an incredibly well-rounded performance here on the road.
And how good a feeling is that for this team to dominate the way they did in front of a hostile crowd? That is a satisfying feeling for the victors.
Roberson gets the bucket.
Well, I tell you what, when you get this kind of effort and efficiency from him, they're a really hard team to beat.
They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. Here's Holiday. Oh, took the contact and tried to throw it down over the top. But instead, he'll shoot free throws.
And guys, more and more, you know, we're seeing the league try to protect the health of the players. I mean, you see the evidence on the court. Over the last 5 years, the league has cut down the number of cameramen along the baselines in half, giving these great athletes a little more runway to land safely.
And speaking of more space for the players, there has even been talk of widening the court. What do you think of that, Clark?
You know, players have gotten bigger and more athletic, so I wouldn't be opposed to maybe widening the lane a bit. I know the owners with those front row seats raking in that cash might not want to expand the court. Oh, a perfect half at the free throw line for them. That'll help their comeback effort for real.
And Clark, those free throws need to continue if they're going to get back in this game.
Now here's Moore. Feeds it to McDermott. And again, no good by Chicago. Morrow kicks to four. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
Talk about a terrific game for Foyt. 15 points. A couple of nice steals, too. This game is all about him right now.
Full domination mode, guys.
At the line, of course.
Free throw, good, four. Hits one, then misses the second attempt from the free throw line.
Well, this is nothing new. There is some debate on how successful max contracts have been in the NBA. A lot of players have demanded max contract money, but haven't lived up to the pay. And in my opinion, there are only about 15 guys worthy of max contracts in the league in any given year.
They're going to turn it over. They couldn't get it inbounds that time.
Yeah. And really, he played mistake-free basketball up to that point. That's the only time he's turned it over so far.
Moore against Singler. Moore passes to Gibson, and he takes that one up and powers it through.
That is some real serious dime dropping there. Exquisite assist.
Well, we were talking about max contracts. There are arguments to their benefits. Commissioner Adam Silver said last year that he feels they help with parity. What do you think?
You know, for the most part, I do believe he's correct. I mean, they do help with parity. For guys like LeBron and Durant, let's face it, the big max contract can be a hindrance. They're probably considered to be worth far more than they're paid. But it's going to be something that is debated back and forth throughout the next negotiations for the CBA.
From 10 feet out, and the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim. 14 points for Doug McDermott. Deep two from Singler, and again it's Oklahoma City. Bulls have gone 7 of 13 from the field here in the fourth. The baseline J. It's Chicago with another bucket.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
And that one's good. McGarry. Chicago has gotten 3 of their 6 three-pointers to fall here in the fourth. For the three, another three for Chicago.
And he found the perfect spot behind the arc there. Big gap in the deep.
Foy from long range. The shot's good. Collison making the play. Foy's got 4 this quarter.
And how about that for a response?
Well, it sounded as though, or at least it looked as though it sounded like, we'll give you a 3, and then we'll take it right back.
McDermott doing all kinds of good stuff. He has 14 points, and he's done a little bit of work behind the arc. He's got a pair of three-pointers.
And you know what? The defenders have that in the back of their minds now. They'll be on him a little tighter. And something that's been whispered about around the NBA is expansion. We know there are some markets that want desperately to have an NBA team. The NBA might not be at 30 teams for the foreseeable future.
Portis, he's checked in for Chicago. And a switcher also for Oklahoma City. Durant's checked in. There are markets in the U.S. that want an NBA team. Seattle, which has been a great NBA friend, has been trying to get a team back since the Sonics left for Oklahoma City.
Clearly, Seattle's the lead name domestically. The NBA has also talked about adding a European division. A lot of different options for expansion. Don't think any will be acted on anytime soon.
Now here is Singler, and Oklahoma City again with the bucket.
Boy, that mid-range jumper is a beautiful thing to have in your bag, and they've had it going today.
And some say it's a lost art, but they're getting excellent results with it tonight.
And again, no good by Chicago.
Boy, from my angle, it looked like it was in the bottom of the net. Looked good from here.
Yeah, I'm about as shocked as you are, Clark.
And that one's good.
Offensively, it's been a perfect quarter for him. He hasn't missed a single shot.
Moore with it. Singler covering. And it's Moore penetrating. Makes the bucket. Now he's got 5 field goals. 5 for 8 in the game.
And you like to see since the half now, he's finally starting to come around.
Here's McGarry. From deep 3-point range. And again, Oklahoma City with the triple.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. 4 of their last 5 makes are from beyond the arc.
And, Greg, it's hard for me to watch this. I mean, the defense practically giving them those shots.
And that's a foul called on Kyle Singler. That's foul number 2 for him.
Well, we all know that number 1 overall picks are incredibly valuable. I mean, they can change the course and face of an entire franchise. Last season, the playoffs were full of teams that featured number 1 overall picks.
Joakim Noah's checked in for Justin Holiday. Moore with the bucket.
It's really been a tale of 2 halves, guys. A slow start, but this quarter, he has really been the man.
The kick out to Westbrook. Noah. Nice D from Brooks. And guys, teams with the number 1 overall pick tend to go very deep in the playoffs. Just the nature of how the NBA lottery and rebuilding structure works.
Yeah, and in the playoffs last season, every team in the conference semis but 1 had a number 1 overall pick on their roster. So that one team was the Grizzlies.
Chicago's gotten 8 shots off from 3-point land and hit half of them. The 17-footer, Noah, and it's good. Assisting on the play with Brooks. 6 points for Joakim Noah. And the Thunder with the possession here. Ibaka, this is to Robertson. From deep. Left side, Adams. Stolen by Brooks. Noah kicks to Moore. And the rejection by Ibaka. And that'll be Oklahoma City's ball as it goes out of bounds. Justin Holliday's checked in for Doug McDermott.
Justin Holliday.
They've been doing a great job of sharing the ball.
Excellent display of team play.
And guys, Sade comes to mind for me because right now that offense, it's a smooth operator.
Sade, I like that, Greg.
And here is Moore following the three from Kevin Durant. Holiday, no one around him. And they come right back with their own three-pointer.
And how about that, responding to the three-pointer against them with a quick one of their own.
Terrific little tay-to-tay going on right now. Back and forth, here we go.
And Chicago has possession, following the three from Kevin Durant.
He's really done a nice job taking advantage of his opportunities in this half.
Ibaka, no luck. And Chicago shooting and hitting almost everything here in the fourth, up around 58% from the field. Knocked away. Westbrook with the steal. Here's Roberson again, Oklahoma City. And for the Bulls, they're shooting a smooth 58% from the field. Everything going according to plan for them on that end.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for Oklahoma City.
Agreed, Steve, and as one-sided as it gets today, you know, Clark, there were some dominant moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
You're right, Kevin. It's hard to think of anything that didn't go right for them. I mean, game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was spot on.
And the wins continue to come in fairly easy for these guys, and what's been a very strong year, to say the least, tonight will push them up to 56 wins.
And by getting a win in the final game of the year between these two teams, they will have saved themselves some embarrassment, ending with a record of 1-2 in their season series against the Bulls.
And you have to look back at this and see the huge game it was for Waiters. He was doing everything right, and the points came in bunches.
Boy, you got to build a wall around the bucket to keep this man down.
You know, Clark, and even then, he might just go over
it. Yeah, he could.
Look at this. Check out the elevation he gets.
Major. Wow, I tell you, I just cannot get enough of those kind of plays. What a rim record.
That was a nice replay brought to you by Kia.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
Westbrook drives in. Got a hand on it. Westbrook against Brooks. Holiday inside the line. Here's Roberson. Down low, outside for Durant. And here's Westbrook from the arc. Great defense that time from Noah.
Jeez, maybe he was trying to show off or something right there.
Is that what you think?
Absolutely.
Instead, it had the opposite effect. He looked foolish.
That free throw missing. Good on the second free throw. There's 25 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. That's good.
And you can hear the disappointment in the crowd tonight. But we saw a team that was just ready to do battle in this arena. They clearly wanted this road.
Crystal clearly. They came in here determined to steal this game, Greg. Their effort level, I thought, was outstanding. And they just took care of business.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They lead by 40. 20 seconds left in the game. What do you think, guys?
You know, this is a timeout maybe just so they can pat each other on the back, because no other reason to call it.
Well, they're really just being conservative, making sure they don't make any last-minute mistakes, I guess. I mean, I have no idea. No idea.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. Guys, your thoughts?
You know, I'm not sure why you call a timeout this late. I mean, the game is more or less over.
I think they might just be taking a few extra seconds to enjoy the win. Is that plausible?
Or maybe just rubbing it in? That's possible.
And he sinks the second. 20 seconds left in the game. Taken away by Holiday. Here's Moore. Connects from three-point range. And out of bounds as the Bulls gain possession.
Not a fan of those kinds of passes.
And Chicago has possession. So no problem for Oklahoma City as they get the win. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
A great game tonight, Kevin, certainly, and one that had plenty of intense moments. How emotionally charged was this team?
Well, we love a physical game. And cheers. But we wanted to come in here and get a win, especially after losing last game.
Kevin, thank you so much. Guys, this is a team with the heart of champions.
All right, Doris, great job. Thanks so much. That's it, folks. The NBA regular season is in the books. This is Kevin Harlan saying thank you for tuning in. And we'll see you next time. But first, the post-game show with Ernie Johnson just a few aisles above us.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Kevin, thank you, and now we get a chance to check out our Jordan player of the game. He put up a new season high tonight, and if he keeps shooting like he did tonight before the season's over, he might top it. A big key to his team's victory here. What'd you think, Shaq?
Man, he gave him a big boost, and they probably didn't even know it was coming. This guy provides such great depth. He's an option that can come through whenever they need him, and they really need him tonight to put a stop to the losing streak.
He was up to every single challenge he faced tonight. He was in such control of the ball game. His showcase of his skill set was awesome.
And that brings us to the end of our broadcast for this evening. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our illustrious 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson saying good night, and we'll see you again soon, but not soon enough.